start, I have a little gift for the two of you. There's a book each. With the Patrice book, you use this to take all your notes. Okay, for today, masterclass, we're going to do guinea fowl Wellington.
Τι πιο παραδοσιακό να βλέπεις σε ένα εστιατόριο του Gordon Ramsay, συγκεκριμένα στο Πετρούς, να κάνουν το Wellington μπροστά σου.
Have you heard of beef Wellington before?
Ναι, έχουμε ακούσει.
And what do you know about beef Wellington?
Γνωρίζω για το beef Wellington ότι είναι ένα πιάτο το οποίο φτιάχτηκε για να γιορταστεί η νίκη ενάντια στον Ναπολέοντα και είναι ένα μοσχαρίσιο φιλέτο μέσα σε μια σφολιάτα με ένα ντουξέλ μανιταριό, μια πάστα από μανιτάρια γύρω το φιλέτο.
Excellent. Yeah, perfect.
Πήρα το πρώτο μπράβο. Εντάξει, μου αρέσει γενικά να διαβάζω. Ελπίζω να είναι το τελευταίο μπράβο που θα πάρω σήμερα.
It's also very much a signature dish of Gordon Ramsay. We've been working on this recipe for the last 12 years. We serve it in a lot of the Gordon Ramsay restaurants around the world. And in this particular one, we do a guinea fowl Wellington. Mm-hmm. So it's not beef, it's guinea fowl. Okay, we're just going to start with it. So to start off with, we're going to make a herb pancake. So in the pancake is eggs, flour, milk, tarragon, and chives. In the pan, a little oil. And pancake batter is a very loose pancake, so it's more like a mm-hmm. crepe. Mm-hmm. So it's very thin, just like a herb pancake.
Στην κρέπα έβαλε κάποια μυρωδικά και θέλω να δω αν όντως υπάρχει νόημα και στο γευστικό κομμάτι.
So as many elements, it's probably about 12 to 15 different stages in the one dish. And we're going to show you as much of the elements as possible. Mm-hmm. So you've got a really thin pancake. Doesn't take too long to cook. We don't want too much colour, just enough to seal it. Next up, you've got the mushrooms, shiitake mushrooms, which we've already pre-diced. Again, just a little olive oil. Just have a rule, one question, one day. That's it. So be careful what question you ask, because you won't have another chance.
Να, ξεκινήσαμε. Καλά. Καλά το λέγα εγώ στην αρχή. Σήμερα δεν την βγάζουμε καθαρή εδώ μέσα. Γυαλίζει το ματάκι του τσεφτζόκι.
Αυτό είναι bullying στην κουζίνα. Να ρωτάς μόνο μία ερώτηση την ημέρα. Δεν γίνεται να μάθεις με μία ερώτηση την ημέρα.
Σεφ, το τρουφόλαδο είναι μέσα στη ζύμη της κρέπας.
So the truffle oil is within the mushrooms. So we saute the mushrooms in truffle oil, salt, and then we add that sauteed mushrooms to the chicken mousse. So we have a pancake. We have our mushrooms, and then from the guinea fowl, so we've got the whole guinea fowl. From this guinea fowl, we've taken the breast off. Uh-huh. All right. With the breast, we place it into a salt water brine, which has garlic, thyme, and 8% salt to water. Okay, so it's 80 grams of salt to 1 liter of water, and that will stay in there for 2 hours. And then you take the fillet and you add it back on. The other way around. This is the fat end and the thin end. So you put the fat end onto the thin end of the breast. Okay? So you roll it up and then cut off. I just want to try and get uniform. So it's all about trying to get everything the same size. And this is why we're rolling it. So it's all nice and neat inside. So you start off with this shape. You can take more cling foam and then roll it on the cling foam. When you roll it on the cling foam, it just acts like a glue. So it sticks to the other cling foam, and that way you can roll it nice and tight. Okay, and then we tie a knot either end.
Είχε κάνει την παλωτίνα μέσα στη μεμβράνη και την τύλιγε πάνω σε μία άλλη μεμβράνη. Λέω, κοίταξε να δεις πόσο απλά πράγματα και δεν τα έχουμε σκεφτεί ποτέ.
Next, we'll take our chicken mousse. So in here, we've just got chicken breast that we've blended with some cream. So this is no eggs, no nothing, just chicken breast and cream. We blend it and then we pass it, so it's nice and smooth. Shiitake. Just mix that together. Then we get our pancake, then add our chicken mousse. So we spread this out, you get a nice and even layer. Add that onto our mousse. Then roll the chicken mousse around the pancake. Okay. And even chicken mousse. We want it all to be even layered all the way around. That way it'll give us even cooking as well. There you have it. You got another. That's the inside of the guinea fowl Wellington. Next stage is the puff pastry.
Μου έκανε πολύ εντύπωση τα στάδια της μπαλωτίνας, μάλλον, που έφτιαξε. Έκανε μπαλωτίνα από την αρχή τη φραγκόκοτα, rolling τη φραγκόκοτα με το pancake, την ξαναέκανε μπαλωτίνα και την ξαναέκανε μπαλωτίνα με τη σφολιάτα. Αυτό με εντυπωσίασε, ότι έκανε τρεις μπαλωτίνες σε μία βερσιόν.
So have you made a Wellington before? I know you know about a Wellington. Have you ever made it before?
No, never.
Yeah, have you made it before?
One time.
One time. And never again.
Απλά το δοκίμασα για εμένα, δεν το έχω κάνει επαγγελματικά μια Wellington. Οπότε το έχω φτιάξει απλά μια φορά για να δω πώς είναι, τι είναι.
Perfect. Good to try these things out, huh?
Yes.
Δεύτερο μπράβο. Καλά πάμε. Ελπίζω να πάρω και άλλα μπράβο στη συνέχεια. Μου αρέσει γενικά να πειραματίζομαι, να λέω πράγματα πώς μπορώ να τα κάνω.
And there you have like the start. Excuse me, that's the start of the guinea fowl Wellington. So then we'll rest that for one more time, and then we're going to glaze it with an egg yolk glaze.
Σεφ, η κρέπα μέσα στο Wellington μπήκε για να μην να τραβήξει, ας πούμε, τα υγρά που θα βγάλει φραγκόκοτα στο ψήσιμο για να μην χαλάσει φωλιά, να μην μαλακώσει.
Puff pastry is made up of layers. You need that to like have a protective dry layer. So it's there for protection from the puff pastry, and it's there for flavor with the herbs, and it's there to keep everything in shape. We egg wash the Wellington. And it's just really important because you want to keep everything beautiful, looking beautiful. You put all this time and effort into getting all the layers. By the final layer, which is the egg wash, we want to get a nice, even layer. So when it bakes, it's all the same color. There's not lumps of egg there, and there's no egg wash there. So this is more of like, this is what you want to present to your guest.
Αυτό που μου κάνει περισσότερο εντύπωση είναι ότι ο σεφ μας εξηγεί ότι για κάθε υλικό, για κάθε Παρασκευή, υπάρχει συγκεκριμένο νόημα και δεν υπάρχει μέσα κάτι για το θεαθήνε, κάτι για το μάτι. Είναι όλα για το γευστικό κομμάτι. Πρώτα η γεύση και μετά η εμφάνιση.
And then I use the back of a spoon, the spoon handle, to then score the pastry. So when we're scoring the pastry, we're not going through the pastry, we're just like making a mark. Like so, and then we go around the side, and then we'll just mark it like this. This is not doing anything apart from making it look pretty. Do you see?
Mm-hmm.
We have a beautiful marked Wellington. And then that's ready for service. So that we put into the fridge, just allowed to set, and then we cook it straight from the fridge into the oven. We start at 210 degrees. For the first 5 minutes, and then we bring the temperature down to 180. And then we get an internal temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. Okay? It sounds undercooked, which it is. It's at 40 inside.
40
and then you take it out. And because it's wrapped in pastry, there's heat. So it's just going to keep on rising and rising and rising. Okay, so the heat will come up to a nice serving temperature of about 60 to 65 degrees Celsius. And then we can slice and serve.
All right.
So I'll just stick this in the oven now.
Όχι, σουφλέ.
Σήμερα θα γίνει πανηγύρι.
Όχι στο τελικό σουφλέ.
So any tricky parts? Wow. Where did I start?
Still hungry?
Starving. Okay, Wellington, out the oven. So, and there we have the Wellington is at 40, and we're just going to allow that to rest and to come up to that temperature, serving temperature.
Σεφ, κάθε μέρα στην προετοιμασία κάνετε στάνταρ μία ποσότητα για το σέρβις που θα έχετε για τους πελάτες. Είναι στο αλακάρτ μενού ή είναι στο degustation και πάντα σερβίρετε κάθε πελάτη το Wellington?
Wellington is one of the Gordon Ramsay's signature dishes. It's on both our lunch and dinner menu. And roughly about every second table will have at least one Wellington, which is a good thing because it means we can keep the mise en place really fresh. Because you don't want to get too far ahead, because what happens, you've got salt in the brine for the guinea fowl. You have salt in the chicken mousse. You have puff pastry. You have the crepe. All those things the next day will not taste the same. So we rely on the chef to really, truly understand how it's made through trial and error. So we have to be so accurate because we don't know until we slice in. If he's read the correct temperature, if he's done the mousse correct, if he's wrapped it correct, nice and tight. You know, all those little things, and we're leaving it to the last minute, slice and serve. So it's very important. Anything at this level is consistency. And that is what we're looking for. That is what I am looking for. You listen and you deliver consistently. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
Nice, sir.
Right, so when it comes to the service, all our vegetables, anything that will come up to the pass, you know, we drain it off. You want to take any of that excess fat. We heat the vegetables up. We pre-cook the vegetables. These vegetables are cooked, salt-baked. So it's in salt and egg white. Yeah. And we get these navi turnips, which is like a white turnip from France. And we bake it in salt. And then we crack it open, and we take off the skin, and we portion. And then we reheat it in an emulsion of stock and butter. And then, in the center of the plate, we have a puree made from the white of the turnip. So we cook it very quickly, slice it very thinly, and then cook it very quickly until it becomes tender. And then we'll put it in a blender and we'll add watercress. So we add the watercress at the last minute, blitz it.
You're feeling the brass, no?
And it keeps it really green and it gives a peppery taste. Next up, we have pickled blackberries. So this is blackberries. So it's almost like it's something we can get ahead of. So when the blackberry season is very good, we'll add the pickled blackberries. Then, in the UK right now, it's the season for the wild garlic. I don't know if you know wild garlic. Wild garlic is this.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like these leaves that we can make an oil from or a puree. We make a crisp. So we blanch it and then lay it on cling film. Oil, salt, and then dehydrate. So you have this beautiful, thin, garlicky crisp.
Και εκεί που νομίζω ότι έχει τελειώσει το Wellington και σκέφτομαι ότι δεν υπάρχει κάποια τραγανή υφή, γιατί έχει πουρέ, έχει λαχανικά, έχει το κρέας, εμφανίζει και ένα φύλλο από άγριο σκόρδο, το έχει κάνει crispy και λέω, να τη κι άλλη υφή. Έξιμο στοιχείο.
And then we have another element of garlic. These are garlic flowers. Okay, so it's just a little bit, quite spicy, quite hot. So you don't need much. But we'll put one leaf, flower head onto each blackberry. We'll slice into the Wellington, so you can hear the pastry. Crackle, so it's nice and crispy on the outside. And then this is the favorite bit, this is the chef's bit. We have in the kitchen, the bit in the end. So we'll have that as a little treat.
Αυστηρός, αυστηρός ο σεφ, κάνει όμως και λίγο χιούμορ. Λέει ότι όταν κόβουμε το Wellington, η γωνία είναι το κομμάτι του σεφ. Όπως έτσι και στην Ελλάδα, στη δική μας χορτόπιτα, μας αρέσουν οι γωνίες. Έτσι, εδώ στην Αγγλία, τους αρέσει η γωνία από το Wellington.
Παιδιά, δεν είναι η λιχουδιά του σεφ, είναι η λιχουδιά του ορθού ανθρώπου. Εσείς, ποια είναι η μάνα σας μια πίτα. Ποιος θα πει, όχι θέλω από τη μέση, δεν θέλω τη γωνία. Πλάκα κάνουμε τώρα.
The breast, the mousse, the pancake, and the crispy pastry. This will sit on the puree. And then we'll finish. We'll finish with a little guinea fowl jus. Guinea fowl jus gras. And then we'll just pour a little bit on the pastry. So a very simple dish, but a lot of work to execute it. Do you want to come and try?
Yes, of course.
Try some?
Από την αλήθεια, εγώ θέλω να φάω τη γωνία περισσότερο.
Εγώ. Δεν το χαλάσετε, δεν
είναι το καλύτερο κομμάτι, οι πίκλες.
Αλήμως,
στο στόμα μου ένιωσα κάτι οικείο. Κάτι που είναι σαν να τρώσει Κυριακή μεσημέρι σπίτι σου και είναι το αγαπημένο σου φαγητό. Αλλά λέω τόσο οικείο με πολλές, πολλές λεπτομέρειες. Θεωρώ ότι το πιάτο αυτό είναι καθαρά Gordon Ramsay και πιστεύω ότι δίκαια το παραγγέλνουν οι μισοί από τους καθημερινούς πελάτες.
Το φιλέτο λαγουέλικνο του Σεφ Πετρί ήταν καταπληκτικό. Δεν έχω λόγια. Υπήρχε μια απόλυτη ισορροπία γεύσεων.
Καλό.
Wow. Φίλε.
Ναι, wow, είναι πάρα πολύ καλό.
It's really good.
Thank you very much.
Σεφ, ήταν πάρα πολύ καλό. Ήταν τόσο τραγανό εξωτερικά και τόσο απαλό μέσα. Η τρούφα, όλα τα στοιχεία ήταν πραγματικά πάρα πολύ καλό.
Το στήσιμο στο πιάτο δεν είναι κάτι wow. Ένα ωραίο στήσιμο. Αλλά όταν το δοκίμασα, μου άλλαξαν όλα. Ήταν εξαιρετικό, τόσο crispy απ' έξω, τόσο μαλακό μέσα. Πραγματικά ήταν το καλύτερο Wellington που έχω φάει στη ζωή μου.
Thank you.
We thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.